Welcome, brothers and sisters. Welcome to a new video of Topical Grace. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Topical Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. The topic of this video is perfect timing. Brothers and sisters, we are watching the sky for the return of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, for the bride, for our bridegroom to come. Now is the time that we have to watch even more diligently. The Lord has given me over the years a personal timeline that is being fulfilled right and left. And out of this personal timeline, I have deducted two options where I believe that it's highly possible that everything will begin. One, the first option is starting in the end of December, going to the 4th of January, beginning then the 40 days. And the second option is similar to it, but starting at the end of January, going to the 4th of February. Brothers and sisters, let's go into it. When would it then all begin and start? Yes, I know, we have the understanding that still something can happen on the 19th. And still something is possible to happen, and it will definitely happen just before Christmas. In my personal timeline, that would be the end of the first 7 years that will come to end around the 22nd of December. Then the next event is now the complete readiness of the children on the 26th. When the Lord has finished his gathering and everything is done, and he is now ready to come for the brides. So the 26th of December would then mark the end of the gathering of the children. And then on beginning on the 28th of December, the 28th and 29th of December would be the beginning of the meeting of the Lord with the brides. And then we will have a final warning over the 30th and 31st of December. Final warning that something bad is happening, that war is coming, that the sealed tribulation will begin. And then on the 1st of January, we will have reports, the first reports of Leah and or Rachel brides that they have seen the Lord. I repeat that again. On the 1st of January, we would have the first reports of Leah and or Rachel brides that they have seen the Lord, that they have met him. In the pattern to Mary Magdala, or Mary Magdalene, whatever you want to call her, so that you know that she has seen the Lord first after the resurrection, on the 1st of January. Then, on the 2nd of January, is a general call for all the brides to come forth. 2nd of January, call for all to come forth. I believe this is a day when the Church of Ephesus, the apostles, the first apostles are called. 2nd of January. The 3rd of January is then, because all this is, you have seen the Lord and we were called forth now into our destiny. That is not necessarily a loop, but it could be a loop. Then on the 3rd, we will have a whole new destiny now ahead of us. A whole new world is standing before us. With the Lord, with our bridegroom together, all this will be reflected on the 3rd day of January. And on the 4th day of January, now will be the 40 days. And the 40 days of Jesus on earth will be a dress rehearsal for what is coming at Mount Zion. It is not the sixth seal at this time, but it will be the 40 days. And this 40 days from the 4th of January will end on the 13th, 14th of February. When now the Lord will then go to Mount Zion and we will start preparing ourselves. The Lord will tell us, wait for my gifts and blessings that will come unto you. Wait for them. 10 more days, then your harvest will begin. And so this 10 more days will then be finished on the 24th of February 2022. That is the 50th day. And then the harvest will begin. And in all this time, in this 40 days, you will have received it all. At the end, you receive the final outpouring, the final helpers will come. You have received before, most likely on the 13th, on the 14th, the mantles that you need to walk it, because Jesus will then ascend to New Zion, where he will be the commander-in-chief of the remnant army of New Zion. And you will remain in your dwelling places, waiting for the last outpouring that will come to make all the harvest workers and all the powerful warriors in the remnant army of New Zion equal. So that the Leah bride has the same understanding and wisdom as the Rachel brides, and so that the harvest can begin. So let me repeat it again. First option. 28th of December. 29th of December. You will feel great love. You as a bride, you will feel great love. Love will be in the air that day. Why? Because your bridegroom, you can see him on the horizon. He is coming towards you. On the 30th, 31st of December, the final warning. War is coming. The seals will begin. Then on the 1st of January, 1st of January, you will have the first report from a bride, either one or many of them, either Leah and or Rachel, that they have seen the Lord. On the 2nd of January, the brides are called. The Church of Ephesus, the first apostles that will be called forth, are called at this day. On the 3rd of January, you have a whole new world. Your destiny is now standing right before you, together with your bridegroom. All is fulfilled. On the 4th of January, the 40 days will commence. I call it a dress rehearsal of what will come later in the sixth seal. This is a dress rehearsal of Jesus coming onto the earth. It's a dress rehearsal. That will finish at the 13th or 14th of February, with the final gifts and blessing bestowed onto you. Then you have to wait 10 days so that every bride is at the same level with the final outpouring at the 50th day. Like a Pentecost outpouring, but not on Pentecost. It's a pattern. Then after the 50th day, the harvest will begin from the 24th of February 2022. Brothers and sisters, everything is in perfect timing. You will see the Lord is coming. After he has finished with the children on the 26th of December, and after the first 7 years have come to an end, the 22nd, just before Christmas, you will feel the love that will come for you, because that's your bridegroom approaching your place and your life, and everything will change. So that was the first option, brothers and sisters. Now, the second option is, if this will not occur in December, what is a possibility? And I will say and will give you the reason why at the end of this video. Then we have a second option that would take us to the end of January, with the 28th of January, 29th of January, the love approaching you, 30, 31st of January, the final warning, 1st of February, the first brides will see the Lord, 2nd of February, you are called forth, 3rd of February, whole new world, 4th of February, 40 days will start. That is also a possibility. Now, brothers and sisters, it is coming to pass. If it's December or if it's end of January, but it will come to pass. No more delay. Everything is in perfect timing. All what has to be fulfilled on my timing to come to my personal timing that the Lord has given me is fulfilled. Nothing is lacking except the coming of our Lord and Savior, our bridegroom, so that he will choose us now and bestow the gifts unto us during the 40 days. Now you will ask me, when will the portal open in all this? Brothers and sisters, that is the timing of the Father. I also cannot tell you when the light will come onto us. I believe that the light latest has to be with us and on our shoulders, the mantle of the light, latest by the 13th to 14th of February or 13th to 14th of March. This is the second option, latest. But it can all be earlier during the 40 days. It's up to the decision of the Father, who will tell our Lord and Savior, our bridegroom, what to do, and then he will bestow it onto us. This is a very high watch time, coming to the end of December, going into January. Stand with the kingdom, stand strong. This is the timing. This is your new destiny approaching. This is love coming for you. The love of our Lord and Savior is coming for you. You will be called into a whole new world, into a new destiny, and into a new life. So now, brothers and sisters, before I will close this video, not to make it too long, so that everyone will watch it to the end, I will tell you why I have two options. This has something to do that I have seen in enemy preparedness in, for example, in iPad Go 2. Remember that scene in iPad Go 2 where you see the skeleton and the fireworks? And then you see that lady and what she has on her jacket, on the back of her jacket, a tiger. And we have always asked ourselves, what does that mean? Has that to do with a tiger nation? What? No. There is another explanation, and that's the reason why. The fireworks, of course, could point us to the end of the year, to 1st of January. And the skeleton then tells us, okay, the time of the seals are coming. Sorry. The time of the seals are coming, and death is approaching. Then the skeleton taps that lady on the shoulder, and she is waving the flag for peace. She realized peace is no more. Peace will be taken from the earth. Because she was waving the white flag to the approaching army, to the approaching tanks. Okay, that one we understand. So it could be 1st of January when this time will come that peace is no more. This is the new year of 2022. Because that's another 222. That is about witnessing now. It will all come to pass and you need to witness. We talked about this many times. Now, why do I think it could be end of January into February? That is because of the tiger. Because the tiger on the back of the jacket of that lady could be a reference to the Chinese New Year. And the Chinese New Year starting in 2022 is the year of the tiger. So it would be a perfect timing. And now you will be blown away when I will tell you when the Chinese New Year is. The Chinese New Year in 2021 is on the 1st of February 2022. Wow. So that's the reason why I say we could have two options. Both the 1st of January, the 1st of February, both are celebrating New Year's with fireworks. The World New Year and the Chinese New Year. Both could be the timing. That's the reason why I say we have two options. The tiger on the back at least would tell us that from the 1st of February 2022, there is no peace anymore in the world. And we see it also, perfect timing, we see it, we see this. This talks have stalled between the US and Iran, and Israel is really aggressive promotion now that they should do something against Iran. There is a war coming, an attack is coming. Either an attack on Iran or Iran attacks Israel, whatever the case, war is coming. So it's fitting perfectly. Because I know that the first attack will be latest in April 2022. Latest. And that will then become bigger and bigger issue in the world until most likely by September, October 2022, we have a World War II, World War III. All this is perfect timing right now. All this, what you see, everything will come to pass. So let me remind you again that the first 7 years will come to an end on the 22nd of December. Then the children are gathered on the 26th. Then the love is coming for you, warning. The first brides will see the Lord. You're called forth, a whole new world. And then the 40 days will start. I praise the Lord. I give him all the glory for all the revelation he is giving us and allowing us to stand so that we are accounted worthy to escape all these things, because we are not escaping to the third heaven. We are escaping to New Zion, and even our dwelling places on earth, as it is written in Scripture, will have a hedge of protection and a covering from the Father, so that we can fulfill our destiny to bring in the harvest. That is also an escape from all these things. You are not belonging, you are escaping from New Egypt. You are not belonging to New Egypt. You will not be bound in that matrix. You will belong to the kingdom of heaven. So you will be worthy to stand before the Son of Man. Yes, we understand that the Leah brides are two groups. The biggest group with the children will go to the third heaven. They are worthy to stand before the Lord. They will go with the Lord. The light will be taken out of darkness. We know this. Genesis 1. And then we see the harvest workers. The first church of the seven churches, the church of Ephesus, the apostles, the new apostles are called for their harvest work. They are a small part of Leah who have volunteered last minute, and the major part and of all of the Rachel ones who are prepared. All these people were predestined right from before they were even placed in the womb of their mothers for such a time as this to do this work. It's all in perfect timing. We are only waiting now for the love to come towards us, for the Lord to reach us, and then everything will change right away. And somewhere in the beginning or in between to the end, we will see that portal that will give us access to New Zion. Must the Lord go first there before us? It's possible. So that would mean then it would be after the 40 days. But do I know it for sure? No, I don't. All I know is everything is now in perfect timing. And we have to stand before the throne in unity, together, not to separate ourselves, but to stand together, not to run away because of fear, not to let the enemy come in to steal our crown, but to stand together in the remnant army of New Zion, ready to be transformed, ready to be transported, ready to receive the light. I hope that this timing will give you hope and give you strength. Take it to the Lord. I know he will not give you the day and the hour. I know. That is not the point. The point is to stand with the kingdom and to come out of the world, Babylon, and the churches. Forget about the church sinking. Forget about all this what the churches are telling you. This spiritual awareness you have finished long time ago. You are much stronger than you believe. Don't fall back into church practices, what they do. Don't. Come out of the world, the churches, and Babylon. Do not at any moment at all fall back into the culture of the churches. You are a powerful warrior. You are a prince or princess of the kingdom of heaven. You are a son and daughter of the Most High. You belong to the royal household. Do you really believe that the Father has chosen you, separated you, made you perfect, and then he will hand you over to Satan? That is a lack of faith, a true lack of faith. The only way that you can give away your crown would be that you turn completely from the kingdom now and go back into the world. That you desire the world more than anything. That would mean you will stop praying, you will stop standing before the throne, you will stop thinking about the kingdom and how to promote it. You will not even think about your destiny anymore. Then you would turn away. Nothing else can hurt you. Only that, your own decision. Then the enemy can steal your crown. But not by small things when he will send a fiery dart against you. You are far beyond that point. You are prepared well. You are strong. You are ready. You are a powerful warrior. That will not hurt you. It might itch you a little bit, but that's all. The only way to that the enemy can steal your crown if he comes and tell you, no, this is not your destiny. Your destiny is the world. And when you then choose the world completely, stepping away from your destiny with the kingdom of God, then you lose your crown. But nothing else can affect you. The Lord has not taken you through the wilderness and everything so that a small fiery dart or whatever the enemy will throw against you will then destroy you. Then how will such an army ever stand on the battlefield against all the demonic forces? It is perfect timing, brothers and sisters. And we have to stand with the kingdom. Let the enemy do what he wants to do. He is given permission. We understand that in seals the 42 months of the Antichrist must come to pass. So the Father must have given him permission. That's the reason why he has also taken us and prepared us so that we can stand against the evil flood. So that he will not, that his whole creation is not suffering alone without any rescue, without any help, without any harvest. And so the same in trumpets. Satan must have his 3.5 years. He must have it. That was an agreement. Do I know how it was made? No. But it's there. He will have his time. Remember the pattern to the servant Job, where also Satan became get the permission from the Father to test your Job. And so now it is coming to testing the whole world. A snare is coming over the whole world. The question is, will you fall into that trap or will you stand with the kingdom? Brothers and sisters, I hope this blessed you, this gives you some understanding where we are, what is possible right to the end of this month, and if not the end of this month, then to the end of January. Everything is in perfect timing. That's the reason why the title of this video is Perfect Timing. Now, stand there, watch the sky, because you will laugh. Your redemption is coming, and so very soon you will see him on the horizon, and then the first reports will come in a pattern to Mary Magdalene, who was the first to meet the Lord. That is a pattern to the brides meeting Christ Jesus first. Brothers and sisters, I love you all so dearly, and I hope that we will all are standing together on the battlefield as powerful warriors in the remnant army of New Zion. You are called, you are chosen, you are separated, and you are much stronger than you believe. Now, stand with the kingdom forevermore. Your bridegroom is approaching. Brothers and sisters, be blessed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Maranatha.